Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, or if none of those apply to you, then just hello. PCB, printed circuit board, by default we think of them as boards that are based for circuits. But they can be used for art and decoration as well. Basically, they are plates with few different colored layers on top of each other, allowing us to create cool graphics. In this video, I will show how I designed these Christmas ornament PCBs. These were ordered from the sponsor of this video, PCBway.com. PCBway.com is an affordable PCB manufacturer who also offers 3D printing and CNC milling services. You can get a handful of PCBs for just $5 plus shipping. PCBway is a great PCB manufacturer for all your prototyping and low volume production needs. Go check out their current pricing and capabilities at PCBway.com. As a starting point, I have this image of a Christmas tree on the left. You could get away with just one image like this, but I had some specific requirements and I wanted the surrounding of the tree to not have solder mask nor copper, so those areas would be translucent. To have copper on specific areas only, I edited the image to be solid black. This will be used to specify that the Christmas tree graphics will have copper underneath. To specify the area surrounding the tree to not have green solder mask, I have also created an inverted version with black extending past the planned PCB outer edge. In addition to preparing those images, I have created a folder where I will save the footprint files. It doesn't really matter where this directory is, as long as it's a logical place so you'll remember it. In KiCad, I will add that folder to list of footprint libraries, so those future footprint files will be found. Preferences, Manage footprint libraries, select Global Libraries tab if you want to use these footprints in other projects as well, and add existing library with the button that has folder in it, and select the folder that was just created. After creating base images, library folder, and adding the library folder to the KiCad, it's time to actually create the footprints from the images. There are a few different ways to do it. I want to learn how to create PCB graphics that are reusable, so I will use the bitmap to component converter inside the KiCad. This will create the footprint library, which can be used in future projects as well. This tool is very simple, but if you prepare the image files in photo editor, this is all you need. I will run this converter 4 times to create different elements. First, copper that fills the whole tree shape. 2. Removing the solder mask from the ornaments. 3. Removing the solder mask from surroundings of the tree. And 4. Outlines drawn in the silkscreen. In copper and silkscreen layers, you'll define where you want them. In solder mask layer, you basically define where you don't want it. That's why I created the inverted mask image in the beginning for the non-solder mask area. I loaded the black tree image in the converter. Very first thing is to decide the size. By changing the DPI, dots per inch, I can set the desired size. Try different values and see how the size changes. Use same DPI for horizontal and vertical. When you come up with good values, remember those, because same values has to be used with other images of the same drawing. Layers of the footprint are single color, so the image will be converted to black and white. The black and white picture tab will show the final version. If the image is color image or grayscale, you can use the threshold slider to select the threshold of black and white. This does nothing with true black and white image. I use PCB new format, the KiCad underscore mod file. This image will be on copper layer, which isn't one of the available layers in this tool. I will select front silk screen and move it manually later. First, this needs to be exported to the folder which was created in the beginning. While I'm in this tool, I will convert rest of the images as well. Next one is removing the solder mask from the ornaments. I could have edited the image in the photo editing software to have black areas where the ornaments are. Instead, I loaded this original image and select negative in image option. But there are additional black areas. But because they are not connected to the ones I would like to keep, I can delete those areas in footprint editor later. It's important to remember to use the same DPI as before. These graphics will go to front solder mask layer, which is available in this tool. Rest of the layers will use the same features of this tool, and I will skip those parts in this video. Once all required layers have been converted from image file to a footprint file, it's time to combine the layers and do any required modifications. In KiCad, there is Footprint Editor, which is suitable for this task. Browsing the list of libraries, there should be the one that was added in the beginning, and if the files were exported to the correct folder, those files should show up as footprints. I have footprint called 3, where I will combine all the layers. Currently, it has the outlines of the 3 in silkscreen layer as planned. I will go to the footprint that is supposed to be the copper layer. The image is in wrong layer, but I can double-click it and select the correct layer, front copper. That was easy. Then select the image, hit Ctrl plus C, and click anywhere in the image to copy it. I'll open the 3 footprint and hit Ctrl plus V to paste the copied copper layer image. Zoom in enough to make aligning the layers easier. Don't forget to save with Ctrl plus S when you are happy with the changes. Next, I will bring the ornaments to the solder mask layer to actually remove the solder mask from those spots. As I said previously, this file has areas I don't want to include in the final footprint. I will hold Shift and click the parts I would like to keep. Then I will copy and paste them to the main 3 footprint file just like with previous layer. At this point, the footprint will resemble the Christmas tree quite nicely, but the green solder mask would surround the tree. Last thing is to add the surrounding of the tree to the solder mask layer. To preview how the final PCB would look like, you can create 3D rendering of the PCB with Alt plus 3. This also works while laying out the PCB. The footprint is ready. The outline will be defined in the layout editor. For this video demonstration, I will create a temporary project and open the PCB file. Hit the Add Footprint button. I should see the Christmas tree footprint in the list. I will add that to the board. I'll quickly select Edge Cuts layer and draw a circle around the tree and smaller circle inside the larger one. Hitting Alt plus 3 will render the PCB in 3D, and we can see a flat Christmas ornament. To add same graphics to the other side, add the same footprint second time somewhere, double-click it and change board side from front to back. It will move all the layers to the other side. Then just align it as you would with any part in this editor. In the future projects, you should be able to add that same footprint with just a couple of clicks without always converting the image. This Christmas tree probably won't be reused, but this was a practice project. Same principle can be used to add, for example, company logo to the custom PCBs. I hope this was useful for your future projects. If so, hit the like button gently. Thanks. Bye.